Pocahontas had to open a casino. And Peter Pan had to cancel his gender affirmation surgery.
Reports next week. Brian Belsky, go first.
Oh,
yeah. You know, and every other Disney shareholder hasn't seen the reaction, though this week it's up near 8%.
You know, we made a mistake, and...
After a century of profitable business and being at the center of magical experiences and adventures for multiple generations, Disney's magic is waning. As we gradually close the curtains on 2023, the multi-company, synonymous with enchantment and entertainment, faces a turbulent journey, and it seems to be getting worse. The company's traditional strategies, such as reimagining animated classics into live-action adaptations, have faltered, leaving it far from the billion-dollar benchmarks it once easily reached. The streaming platform Disney Plus, once hailed as a potential savior, has been marred by substantial losses and subscriber attrition, despite efforts to raise subscription fees and introduce ads. Disney's theme parks, a cornerstone of its legacy, have faced challenges with declining foot traffic and pricing decisions that have caused public backlash. What exactly is going on? A losing streak? When the movie The Little Mermaid was released, there were high expectations for it from industry experts and Disney itself. The company had poured in a ton of resources and looked forward to making it big at the box office. Unfortunately, the outcome was simply disappointing, and this was not the first time. Other releases like Indiana Jones and The Dial of Destiny and Elemental also turned out to be huge failures. Screen Rant reported that Disney was the big loser of summer 2023, with $900 million in box office disappointments. The magical enterprise has consistently dominated the film industry, delivering both cherished animated classics and successful live-action productions. With ownership of renowned franchises like the MCU, Star Wars, Avatar, and a treasure trove of iconic classics, Disney has maintained its status as a cinematic powerhouse. Nevertheless, the summer of 2023 posed challenges as several major box office disappointments led to an approximate $900 million loss for the company. Disney's strategy of reimagining animated classics into live-action adaptations has yielded substantial profits in past years. Films such as Maleficent, Cinderella, and The Jungle Book proved to be highly lucrative. Beauty and the Beast, Aladdin, and The Lion King each surpassed the billion-dollar mark at the box office, with The Lion King even becoming the highest-grossing animated film of all time. However, the reception towards these remakes has begun to wane, and there was anticipation that The Little Mermaid would revive Disney's glory once more. Regrettably, this expectation did not materialize. The Little Mermaid grossed slightly over $561 million, a figure that would be considered a substantial success for most films. However, this achievement is somewhat diminished by the film's hefty production budget of $250 million. It's important to note that these budgets do not encompass marketing and distribution costs. In Hollywood, a general rule of thumb dictates that a movie typically needs to earn about 2.5 times its budget to break even. In the case of The Little Mermaid, it would need to reach approximately $625 million at the box office to start generating a profit. Consequently, not only did The Little Mermaid fall short of Disney's $1 billion benchmark, but it also performed so poorly that it incurred significant losses. Another one of Disney's expected box office wins was Pixar's Elemental. The company had high hopes for Pixar's Elemental, anticipating another box office triumph because Pixar films are often major hits at the box office. But Elemental deviated from this trend. It recorded one of Pixar's weakest opening weekends to date, starting sluggishly with a mere $29.5 million in box office earnings. Despite eventually amassing over $395 million in revenue, the film's substantial $200 million budget suggests that Elemental might not have turned a profit. Some industry experts speculate that it could experience a resurgence when it becomes available on Disney Plus. Yet even Disney's streaming platforms are grappling with substantial challenges. Disney launched its streaming platform Disney Plus in 2019, and it rapidly gained popularity, amassing nearly 200 million subscribers by 2022. However, recent data paints a grim picture. Since its inception, the streaming platform has accumulated losses of approximately $11 billion. By the start of the third quarter, it had already suffered a loss of $512 million, coupled with the exodus of nearly 12 million subscribers. This substantial loss followed the company's attempt to make the platform more profitable by raising subscription fees from $8 to $11. It seems that a significant portion of subscribers either disapproved of this increase or could not afford it. To compound matters, Disney plans to introduce ads to the platform, offering subscribers the option to pay $1.14 for an ad-free version. CEO Robert A. Iger maintains that these price hikes are a strategy to bolster the company's finances, aiming to shift more subscribers to the ad-supported tier. However, it appears that more users are leaving the platform than anticipated. These woes are affirming fears and speculations that gathered more wind in November 2022 when a leaked memo exposed a troubling reality. Over $1.4 billion in operating losses from Disney's streaming services for just one quarter. Nearly a year later, the situation has deteriorated, with losses extending to all three major areas of Disney's operations. The company derives revenue from its renowned theme parks, streaming platforms, and studio productions. In the past, this diversified approach allowed Disney to manage losses effectively, but now, all three sectors are faltering, and there's no stable ground to support the company. In the traditional television industry, Disney is also experiencing significant setbacks. A third of its operating profits come from older channels like ESPN and ABC, both of which have suffered substantial setbacks. They recently reported a 23% decline in quarterly profits, with an operating income of just $1.9 billion. This decline is attributed to reduced advertising revenue, rising sports programming costs, declining viewership, and lower subscription payments from ESPN subscribers. Disney's management is contemplating selling a portion of the company and is seeking strategic partners to help with distribution or content. They have approached major sports leagues, including the National Football League, the National Basketball Association, and Major League Baseball, in their quest for minority stake acquisitions. The outcome of these negotiations remains uncertain. The only good news as Disney navigates its current storm is that ESPN, a Disney subsidiary, is exploring new avenues to align with the company's family-friendly brand. Rather than becoming a sportsbook, ESPN has signed a decade-long deal with a casino company to create an online sports betting brand valued at $2 billion. This move offers a glimmer of hope for ESPN's financial prospects as it enters the billion-dollar gambling industry. It is unlikely that this will be big enough to save the sinking giant, but fingers remain crossed. Disney World is down. In August 2023, Disney's stock took a significant hit as shares plummeted to a 9-year low. This decline followed a notorious 44% drop at the end of 2022. While analysts hold out hope for a positive future, the company's massive $48 billion debt has forced Disney to take drastic cost-cutting measures, leading to the layoff of over 7,000 employees out of its 220,000-strong workforce. A significant number of these employees worked at Disney's iconic theme parks, which have also suffered declining foot traffic. Disney World, once the ultimate destination for family vacations and holidays, has faced numerous challenges. First, the COVID-19 pandemic caused devastating closures of parks worldwide. Even after 3 years, the park struggles to recover, partly due to rising ticket prices, now around $100 per person per day. Critics argue that the park no longer offers many free activities or attractions, contributing to its declining popularity. Disney's newest attraction, the Galactic Star Cruise, opened its doors in March 2022, but was closed in May 2023. Disney cited a business decision as the reason for the closure, but it's clear that the luxury experience, costing a family of $4,000-$6,000, was out of reach for many fans. Disney's pricing decisions have raised eyebrows, and the company's new CEO, Bob Iger, has faced public backlash. A CEO problem? Disney's woes have been attributed to past CEO Michael Damon Eisner's ill-fated investments, including substantial expenditures on now-defunct attractions at Disney World. His successor was CEO Bob Iger, who held the position for 15 years before handing over to Bob Chapek, who held the position for only 2 years before Iger made a comeback after a series of dramatic events between him and Chapek. Now, Iger is saddled with the responsibility of setting Disney back on track. He initially appeared to be steering the company in the right direction, particularly as regards streaming. Iger's strategy of providing affordable rates and an abundance of content has undoubtedly struck a chord with consumers, resulting in almost 158 million Disney Plus subscriptions. Nevertheless, this expansion has come at a significant cost. Disney's direct-to-consumer segment, encompassing Disney Plus, reported a $4 billion deficit in the previous year. Additionally, the ongoing strikes by the Screen Actors Guild and the Writers Guild of America forced Disney to postpone the production of new content, a pivotal element in the company's goal to achieve profitability in streaming by 2024. Perhaps it was the frustration from this delay that prompted him to make a rash statement for which he faced widespread criticism. In an interview, Iger described actors and workers demanding higher wages and limitations on artificial intelligence use as unrealistic. This comment fueled public outrage, especially in light of Iger's $31 million annual salary. In response, Disney is now hiring a PR specialist at a cost of $330,000, despite its tight financial situation. Disney keeps making effort, but fans are getting weary. As Disney's content becomes increasingly predictable, audience fatigue is setting in, and fans are growing less enthusiastic about new releases of old shows, even as Disney pours billions into production. Many fans are calling for fresh, creative stories and content. Additionally, Disney has made several unpopular decisions that have upset parents and older fans. The company appears to be disregarding the sentiments of its audience, from significant changes to iconic films like Snow White, including alterations to The Seven Dwarfs, to allegations of gender-based propaganda. A recent TikTok collaboration with a male influencer dressed as Mickey Mouse has further fueled controversy, tarnishing Disney's reputation. Disney is at a crossroads, with its future prospects uncertain. It is faced with the challenge of remaining a source of magic and wonder while navigating a changing landscape. Time will tell whether Disney can weather this storm or if it will face an irreversible decline. The magic Disney once offered now seems out of reach for the middle class due to high prices. As the middle class grapples with economic challenges, Disney appears to be turning its attention to a wealthier minority. The question remains, can this elite patronage keep the Disney ship afloat? Indeed, only time will reveal whether the magic that made Disney an iconic brand for generations can be rekindled, or if it will continue to grapple with its unprecedented downfall. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more updates.